Even though we have gone a longer road than anyone else here at Worlds, there's never really going to be satisfaction for any one of us until we actually win the whole thing.
And Fnatic do the unthinkable and make their way to the quarterfinals.
我觉得Fnatic从二杠四晋级大家都可能觉得是个奇迹，但是我觉得他们走到现在完全是用光了自己所有的运气。我会跟我的队伍用绝对的实力把这个如果的可能性降到零的。直接抓飞机，虽然拿守贝美了，是地美了。因为在国内比赛的话，因为台下观众呼声特别高嘛，所以说也会更加激励自己，就想更好的去打好这个比赛。
The fact that RNG are our home favorites is actually going to be in our favor. I've been on the side before that they are now, where you have everyone backing you up, and I felt the pressure, the unnecessary pressure that comes with it. We know that we can use that to our advantage. No one expects us to do pretty much anything in this series, and it just makes it so much sweeter as well when we come out victorious.
Welcome back to the Guangzhou Gymnasium for day three of the quarterfinals. Teams load in for a big day of action, and MLXG is out front and center, ready to lead RNG versus Broxa and Fnatic, who showed up in the group stage, and they won't go down without a fight. Reckless as well, making his way to the stage. The crowd here definitely in favor of the hometown favorites, RNG. The first of the LPL tapes to teams rather to take the stage in the quarterfinals. But now it's time to send it down to Rendong to introduce today's teams.
欢迎来到广州，现场所有的召唤师们，让我感受一下你们的热情好吗？你们是最棒的。那么在所有的召唤师们的热情之后，接下来让我们请出的就是2017英雄联盟全球总决赛四分之决赛第三组的两支战队，让我们欢迎战队登场。 首先，让我们欢迎的就是蓝色方，来自于欧洲 LCS 赛区的传统豪门，欢迎 Fnatic。
Walking into the lion's den, from 0-4 to quarterfinals, they did the unthinkable, and they're here to do it again.
上路 ，Soyz。 打野 ，Burkhead。 中路 ，Caps， 下路 ，Reckless， 辅助 ，Jerseys， 同样欢迎他们的教练员 Dylan Fico 以及替补中路 Special。 让我们再一次欢迎 Fnatic。接着我们要请出的是今天的红方，来自于本土 LPL 赛区的 RNG。
Don't need much of an introduction here. The all Chinese team looking to be the first of the LPL squads to move on to the semifinals.
上路 ，Let me。 打野，麻辣香锅。中路，小虎。下路 ，UZI。辅助 ，Ming。 同样欢迎他们的教练员 Firefox 峰哥以及替补打野遗憾，拿出你们的呐喊声，让我们再一次欢迎 RNG。英雄，制主传奇 比赛现在开始。
The stage and the stadium shaking there with cheers as RNG took to the stage, and Fnatic have a tough road ahead of them as they try to be the first team to take down a hometown favorite here in the quarterfinals. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm James Dash Patterson here for another day of action alongside Indiana Frosker in black, Alberto Crumbs-Rengifo, and Isaac Azale Cummings-Bentley. A five-game series yesterday that left the world stunned to some degree. Are we ready for another one? Have you guys gotten some rest?
Oh, I'm ready.
You ready? You sure
you're ready? I'm ready.
Yes.
I'm
ready. Five?
Yeah, let's go five.
Let's go five. All right, let's set the table as we pull up the bracket. The crowd has packed the stadium to see RNG take on Fnatic today. And then, of course, tomorrow, the LPL's Team WE aim to take down Cloud9. And halfway through our quarterfinal week, we've already had some pretty historic matches highlighted by yesterday's series, SKT versus Misfits.
I mean, the thing was, is coming into yesterday, I thought I was going to be able to keep dinner reservations. This was going to be clean, quiet, over quick. And Misfits said, no, we will not go quietly into the night. Ignar, in particular, made a hero of himself yesterday as they went the distance.
And it wasn't just euphoric for Misfits in Europe. It was euphoric for the tournament. We finally shed away the Ardent Sensor meta, and the tank and engage supports are coming back, and they have been long awaited.
And I think that's so much about what it was. It was confidence in their own play. Misfits confident to play their own style and showing us a new way to play in this meta and showing that it can work even better than what we had seen before. It was just so incredibly impressive.
And SKT pushed to the limit, having to adapt in a way that they hadn't before to win that very fifth game and move on to the semifinals.
And it was the fact that SKT had to adapt to Misfits. You know, Misfits made them bend to them. Of course, SKT, the champions that they are, they didn't break, but they certainly had to reevaluate their style.
This close.
Single team fight.
Well, we'll see who can make their region proud with today's match as we welcome an all-Chinese team versus an all-EU team.
And this is also another historic moment. You know, since the collapse of 2015, I don't really want to think about the dark LGD days. We then had the rebuilding of 2016 and finally the possible return of the LPL to glory in 2017. Behind us, Reckless said it in his interview, there is a massive spotlight and so much pressure for this all-Chinese roster to perform in China.
And every time Uzi comes to Worlds, he seems to get to the finals. He's been there twice. He's looking to make it a third time. And this guy has been so incredible as one of the great all-time AD carries.
He has been. And unfortunately, he has never quite made it to the very end. Remember, he's made it to two Worlds finals so far, reached it, but just not quite enough. And now this is the only time that every time that they have been in Worlds, they always make it.
But we have to talk about the drive, right, that brings you there. That's brought him back to yet another Worlds and another run at that finals and being perhaps the LPL's best opportunity of taking the title.
It's the legacy there. And on the other side of that, there's also Reckless. These guys have been playing for so long. Again, Reckless's Eyes on World episode, he talks about, you know, if I ever lose that momentum, I just remind myself, this is what I'm here for. Yes, they both have that insane drive. They wouldn't be here if they didn't have it, but they also have kind of that darker side of a lot of that passion.
Yeah, I mean, it's so much emotion in both of these players, and I think it can be for better or for worse, right? If you can actually control that and channel that. We saw in Eyes on Worlds, you know, Reckless talking about how much it meant to him and how much these games affect these players. That can drive you to another level to really succeed. And sometimes, if you let it go too far, it can be the reason you lose.
Right. It's another level, but it can also knock you down because these two teams, these two players specifically that are the, kind of the crown jewel of their teams, or at least at times, they can drag them down. You've seen Reckless, the best game of his life, in his opinion, was one that he actually was making the game losing mistakes. So when we look at that first game, the momentum that comes from that is going to be huge for determining the series.
Yeah, it could be your greatest weapon or your greatest downfall.
I wasn't going to mince words. We have literally seen Uzi cry multiple times on stage where his team has to come out from the back. He doesn't go back into the huddle with them. He forces the coach to come to him, to bend down next to him and make sure that he's okay. And that cannot happen today.
All right, well, we put a spotlight on the two big stars, but I want to talk about what other factors we think might tilt this matchup one way or the other.
For me, it's all about the style, actually. You know, looking at Fnatic versus RNG, I actually probably favor Fnatic's chances a lot more than other people just because RNG love to teamfight. They have a ridiculous teamfight KDA, but Fnatic also like to do that. And so I feel like this is going to be two teams that'll just plant their heels and run full force at each other, and it's just going to be who has the better execution on the day for that composition.
So I'm also taking the meta into account for this because yesterday we saw the rise of the engaged supports. No more of Janna and Lulu. Sure, they were banned at times, but the priority of these elder champions that were before this new patch just soared. And so when you come with that into this matchup, you look at Ming. He has been a stellar support for RNG, especially on the engaged champions. And I just think that he and Uzi will just trump Reckless and Jessis, which are the way that Fnatic wins.
And speaking of Ming, we saw Leona yesterday. Ming has played 4 games of Leona this split.
I like the sounds of that, but I've got to say I'm looking a lot at Broxah because I think when you're going up against a team that's playing the same style as you, this team fighting team that wants to wait for certain item completions, that wants to team fight you, and is probably a better version of what you are doing, you need to get ahead early. And we saw that in the games Fnatic was successful, it was all about Rek'Sai. It needs to be all about the early game, the Lee Sin, the Rek'Sai, the Elise for Broxah, get his team ahead before Uzi can complete those 2 items and they can have the team fight that they want.
All right, well, we got a couple paths for to victory rather for both of these teams. Now, keeping all that in mind for our first quarterfinalist, or rather, let me start that one over. Keeping all these paths of victories in mind, it's time for predictions. Down the line, Frostcurd, starting with you.
I'm going to go for RNG, but I actually think it's going to be a much closer series than I think a lot of people are expecting that. And like I said, I think Fnatic and RNG are stylistically very similar. I'm going to go 3-2. I think we're going to go the distance, simply because someone's going to mess up. Someone's going to give, you know, a Galio or a Jarvan away, or maybe even Maokai makes his return, and we're just going to see these giant titans clash.
I'm going with RNG going 3-0 on this one. Even though the predictions for the past 2 days have been not good, today, when you look at this matchup and consider what happened to Longju against Samsung, it turns out that, in my opinion, Group B was a lot weaker than we expected. And this Fnatic is still the same Fnatic that went 0-3 in week one. I still see them, sure, they got those 4 wins at the end, but this is the same Fnatic that got 0-3, and I just don't see them beating RNG that was in that super strong Group C.
It is the same team, but we've seen how much adaptation can mean between groups and the quarterfinals, how much better Samsung, for example, looked, how much worse Longju looked, and how vulnerable even SKT looked. So while I do still favor RNG in this series, I think Fnatic does have ways in, and it's through the early game, it's through the improved performance of Soaz in week 2 of groups, it's through the early game aggression of Broxah, and to me, that will give them at least 1 game, and I think it's going to be a 3-1.
So I actually think we're nearing the end of adaptation here, because a lot of it came from the bottom side of the map, and the early game junglers can matter a lot. But for the rest of the map, I don't think much more is to be added to the champion pools. And with that in mind, the same stylistic matchups or same style for both these teams, I just favor RNG even more because of that.
I actually have a couple of questions about the jungle, but I don't think we'll see it today. I think that's more for Cloud9 and Contract to continue to evolve the meta, but I don't think we've seen the end of more of these range style junglers.
And I mean, even things like the Caitlyn, which we thought was going to be such a big deal coming into quarters yesterday, came out 1 game, but was not really that impactful in the series. You know, the Chinese teams like playing this lane dominant style. Reckless does as well. So something like that could really shake up what Pick and Ban looks
like. Well, something we'll have to track throughout the day. 73% of fans locked in RNG to take the series and face SKT in Shanghai alongside Mr. Perfect Bracket from the LAN. So you guys are in good company having all of our bases covered for an RNG victory. Before we jump into the match, though, Cap shares his thoughts on what it's like playing against the crowd favorites in Guangzhou.
So I think this is the first time, probably, we have ever played a game where we weren't the favorites. I mean, not the favorites as in favorites to win, but the crowd favorite. It's always, it's also pretty nice, kinda, to be in the other side, because you feel like you're playing to silence the crowd. You know, you're playing against everyone. It's not just you as 5v5. It's you against everyone, and everyone are hoping for them to win, and all the odds are against you. And it's definitely a fun experience.